Look, this is no time for talking. If we don't push the Sith back or get the station evacuated in time, this is going to be a disaster.
Good luck, sir. We're counting on you.
Fandigo Delva, Abuelta, Linda Truth, Oisidan Delva, Badino Delva. Un Truth Brava, Fandigo Delva, Oisidan Delva, Badino Delva. Abuelta, Rendundas, Oisidan Delva. Abuelta, Delva, Badino, Delva.
I must leave you for a time to gather my Mandalorian warriors. We will rejoin you when the time comes for the assault on the Ravager. Don't worry about me. I can handle myself just fine. Look after your own health.
Ready.
All right, men. The Sith are trying to hold us up in this compound. We need to break through or our reinforcements won't be able to move out. Now let's punch a hole in this Sith barricade.
Thank you. Thank goodness you're here. We just can't seem to make any progress against the Sith line. After they established their position, they brought out their turrets. They've been devastating our numbers. We managed to take a few out, but they just keep unloading more of them to replace the destroyed ones. It's up to you to help us throw them back. We gotta get them cleared out of here, and then we're ready for one last charge. All right! Everyone provide covering fire for the Jedi, then advance on the Sith positions. We'll be right behind you. Good luck.
Time to even the odds.
Well, I'm not dead. I guess that's something. I got hit by a grenade. I just barely missed the whole blast. Ugh. They're moving ahead towards the TSF office. It's tough going, though. The Sith, they seem to be everywhere. Well, that's a relief. Of course, if we can't stop the Sith from destroying the fuel controls, it won't matter one bit. If I'm good enough to survive this, then I'm good enough to join the fight.
This area is secure. We can take it from here.
This area is secure. We can take it from here.
We will join you in the assault. These rank and file soldiers will do you no good aboard the Ravager. Let we Mandalorians lead the charge into battle and to victory. Kelborn, Zuka, you will be joining us.
You will not face this alone. I will go with you and be by your side. I would have it no other way.
Just say the word.
Are your preparations complete?
Sir. Sith warship dead ahead of us. It's attacking Citadel Station.
Let's close the trap. Concentrate all fire on the warship and deploy red and blue wings to engage enemy fighters.
Sir, at this distance, our weapons will barely scratch it.
We can't hope to match its firepower, but we need to draw it away from Telos.
Sir, if it keeps firing on Citadel Station, the station won't be able to maintain its orbit.
I am aware of the situation, Lieutenant. I do not intend to lose Telos twice. And I know that ship. It was a Malachor 5.
Mandalore. We have breached the hull of the Sith vessel and are securing the area. The vessel has suffered extensive structural damage, but its particle fields still maintain a minimal atmosphere within the ship.
And our cargo?
It's being brought aboard. Soon, teams will be dispatched to the target sites.
Do the Republic forces suspect?
No, Mandalore. The proton cores do not emit a signature the Republic ships can detect. If they do pick up the signal, they will assume it to be emanating from the ship's missile bays.
Did you get an ID signature on this vessel?
You were right about the vessel, Mandalore. It is of Malachor. It still bears the wounds of Mandalorian guns.
Then let's finish this. And remind the galaxy of Malachor 5.
What was that about?
Nothing you need to worry about, Sith.
You are coming with me.
Don't get all sentimental. I just don't trust you to get the job done. Been waiting for this for 10 years. It's just time to do things the old-fashioned way. we've reached one of the target sites. Place the proton core, prime it, then give the signal, Mandalore. Arming signal received, Mandalore. The proton core is active. We still need to set 3 more charges. Mandalore, we are holding our position, but the Sith appear to be offering little resistance. It's like they don't even realize we're here.
Thank you. Thank you.
reach one of the target sites. Place the proton core, prime it. Then give the signal, Mandalore. Arming signal received, Mandalore. The proton core is active. Two more sites are left. We've lost contact with two of our squads, and we've had to fall back to the docking area.
Strong to ignore. General Vatu and I, when it seemed that we would need more to take Onderon, made it strong again. He came with his power, his soldiers. It seemed as if there was nothing we could not do. Nothing the Queen could do to stop us.
I have served the wrong master. He cares nothing for Onderon, its soldiers, its people. Everything exists to feed his will. I came here, to this dead ship, and now he will not permit me to leave. This ship, it is a graveyard of a terrible battle. Everything on it slowly dies, as long as he hungers.
It is the way of all life that serves him. In his presence, all life dies.
This ship is from Malachor. This Sith Lord of yours bolsters his fleet with ships from that world? He's nothing more than a scavenger.
I think he is of that place. If so, then his power may be great indeed. Greater than I had thought.
The Master suffers. If he cannot feed, then the hunger begins to consume him. The planet, Telos, we feed on something of uncertainty to sustain him a while longer.
You think to lie to me still? I will not be deceived again.
I told him. I told him of the Academy here,
of the Jedi here. I could not have kept it from him, even if I had wanted to.
He means that Jedi witch you travel with, Kreia.
Yes, the old woman on Onderon. She spoke of the Jedi Academy here on Tilos, and my master was forced to come here. Then her lies will mean the planet's destruction. He will destroy all of Tilos. He will turn it to fire again and crush the planet beneath him. He will devour them all, murder them all.
If there are no Jedi here, then my lord cannot feed his hunger. He will destroy the planet, the station. He will cleanse it of life. Even if the people below are not Force-sensitive, the small amount he can feed on from the mass destruction of the station and the life on the planet will sustain him a while longer. And if there are no Jedi below, he will have no other choice. Then he will suffer. Without something to sustain him, I do not know what will happen.
Countless other worlds that depend on its survival.
You could not stop him even if you wanted to. And you cannot escape either. If the Force runs through you, he will feed on it when Citadel Station dies. Your time, your life, will end here. Waits.
Waiting for you.
No. He does not.
I do not believe he knows his ship has been boarded, and if he did, he would not care. The extent of his power cannot be put into words, and his perceptions have grown as well. To him...
You are dust motes in a storm, a grain upon the beach, and as insignificant as a body that orbits the graveyard of Malachor. Fight him if you will, but if he turns his power upon you, you will be destroyed. This ship, is it his weakness? It should not exist, yet it cruises the darkness between the stars. He tore it from the mass shadows of Malachor, along with his fleet. That is a measure of his power.
The ship is barely holding itself together. The structural damage should have destroyed it long ago.
He holds it together. And he keeps us all alive. Just enough. Like rotworms within a dying beast.
More Jedi tricks.
Jedi at all.
If he's so powerful, why hasn't he stopped us then? We've attacked his ship, killed his soldiers, and he's done nothing.
It is because he sees planets, stars, not people. To him, the planet below, the station with its teeming life, only that is massive enough to demand his attention.
Destroy you, and your last moment shall be of shadow and pain. Onderon is already doomed. Better a quick death at the hands of the Sith than a slow death at the hands of the Republic.
Hunger that fills this vessel. It is power, but it consumes without end. It is that power we felt on Onderon, that Vaklu felt. It was an echo, too strong to ignore.
My only crime was Onderon's salvation, and now those hopes have turned gray.
Kill me now, before they are stripped from me forever. You are right. The choice was mine. And you knew! what would happen to me.
Like we were fighting in tandem as a force bond. But I do not feel the same connection. Your impulse to kill, to attack that one, I felt it mirrored in me. It was a strange sensation. It was as if I had no choice in the matter. Yes, that bond that develops between master and their apprentice, or between those that feel the force. Traumatic moments can bind, just as proximity and slow growth may bind as well. Perhaps, nevertheless, the impulse was strong. Yes, that bond that deep traumatic moments can... This story leads to my cell. I had forgotten. If there is time, I would like to center myself. There is a meditation chamber within my cell that I would visit one last time. Past the surface, there is the Force. Where once there was a world that was strong in the Force, now there is a barren wasteland.
It's okay. It's good.
It has taken time for me to return here. I lost my way, but I've been stronger for the journey. What happens now shall not be done out of hate or revenge, but for the sake of all life. This body is a prison no longer. This door leads to the bridge and my former master. If you wish to gather your strength, this is the last time. No, do not harm him. I am the one who has betrayed you. I am the one who should suffer. I will return to you. But please, do not harm him. Do not what you did to me. I beg you. Cannot hold him for long. Follow wherever your path takes you. My path is at an end.